Hello students, so in the previous class we have discussed about that the general characteristics of Cylindrata we have completed, Tenophora also we have completed, and apart from that Platelminthes, Ascalminthes, Annelida. Now today we are moving toward the next phylum, that is Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda. We are moving toward the phylum Arthropoda. So now, what the main characters are going to be found in the case of Arthropoda? Number one, you can see that the meaning of the phylum. Meaning of the phylum, we have to observe that. That is, the animals bear jointed legs. The animals bear jointed legs. This is the meaning of the phylum. Arthro, the jointed, you can see that the and poda andre legs. So now the animal bear jointed legs and appears to be single largest phylum So the animals bear jointed legs and appears to be single largest phylum. So why I am telling you all those things? Because enormous amount of the organisms which is going to be found in the case of Arthropoda. As already you know that right from the insect itself, several kinds of insects are going to be found. So majority of the organisms which are belonging to the kingdom Animalia are related to the Arthropoda. That is why you can see that it is the single largest phylum in the case of the animal kingdom. So now next is second one, habitat. Habitat, you can see that almost all kinds of environment they are going to survive. Now, that is also considered as an cosmopolitan antakaritu. Cosmopolitan means almost all kinds of the environment. They are present in the aquatic, they are present on the terrestrial, they are present on the aerial also, you can see that. So, aquatic, aerial, terrestrial. So all these are the mode of life, and even they are also present in the moist soil, they are also present in the crevices. So that is why we are observing it as an normally cosmopolitan antakaritu. So we have to write here, these are aquatic, Uttagadidra directly you can see that aquatic or terrestrial or aerial, so now or moist soil, etc. etc. That is why in the bracket we have tried cosmopolitan. Cosmopolitan means almost all kinds of environment they are surviving. That is what we are saying it as an cosmopolitan antakarit. Next is third character we have observed that I told you how to write the characters. More character in Brevikandre, these are triploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical, eucilomate, segmented. All those characters we have observed here, triploblastic, bilateral symmetrical, eucilomate, segmented. This character we have studied in the case of Annelida also. So here also we can see that eucilomate, segmented with organ system grade of organization. Next, fourth character is, now we are moving toward the general characteristics of particular Arthropoda. This one daithu. Jointed legs is the unique character, appears to be the single largest phylum is also unique character. And anyway, normally you can observe that habitat, it is common to all, and these are triploblastic, this is also common. But now we are studying the Arthropodan character, which is very important, right? Body is body is made up of chitinous exoskeleton. So body is made up of chitinous exoskeleton or covered by chitinous exoskeleton. So what do you mean by term chitinous exoskeleton? Means here it is not the bony. Chitin is nothing but the hard. It is a polysaccharide material, you can observe that the. So chitin is going to be found hard. Hardness is normally, for example, cockroach leg you have to observe, and even you have seen that the below the wings only kuda you can observe that the segmentation, what we are saying that it is hard. Skin is hard and now it is because of made up of chitin substance, you can see that. However, we have seen in the case of the silval is made up of the chitin and the fungi nalli yavathana nodiddu. So like that here also body is made up of the chitinous exoskeleton. Exoskeleton andre skeleton male, andre skeleton is normally made up of adakke adu hard irutha anta artha. Skeleton is made up of chitin. Next is body is made up of chitinous exoskeleton, and even you can see that the some of the animals or the organism which are belongs to the arthropoda specialized character is there. Sometimes periodically shedding of the exoskeleton is also taking place. Periodically shedding of the exoskeleton andre now we can observe that as the animal grows, removal of the skin is also taking place. That is called as shedding of the exoskeleton. So this process is called as, this is an extra character you can see that, shedding of the exoskeleton periodically is considered as a molting. Shedding of exoskeleton called as a molting anta kuda karithu. Shedding of the exoskeleton is called as a molting. So shedding of the exoskeleton considered as a molting anta karithu andre removal of the skin. Now as far as that part is considered, you can see that for example silkworm is there. Silkworm, the developmental stage, first it is of normally say the larval stage is of 1 centimeter and it grows up to 7 centimeter. While the growing, you can observe that the shedding of the skin is also taking place. Ili shedding of the skin yak aagtandre it resembles the growth, andre it indicates the growth of the animal. That is what we are considering it as a molting anta karido. This is also a special character in the case of arthropoda. So body is normally covered by chitinous exoskeleton or made up of chitinous exoskeleton which periodically sheds andre as the development occurs. So shedding of the exoskeleton takes place. Exo means outside. Shedding of the exoskeleton takes place is called as molting anta karito. This is an extra character you can observe, right? Next is fifth one. Body is divided into number of characters what we are observing here, you can see that in the case of arthropoda body is divisible into head, comma, thorax and abdomen. Body is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen. So this is a new character what we are observing here. Body is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen. So far we have seen that normally head region anta nodiddu. Actually head region formation is to be taking place in the case of annelida, cephalothorax. So now what we are observing that the head region is going to be formed in the case of the annelida itself. So head, thorax and abdomen is normally found separately. Head, thorax and abdomen which is going to be found here. First time in the animal kingdom what we are saying it as a divisible of the body which may takes place head, thorax and abdomen. Thoracic region andre chest region, abdomen region andre lower part. You can take the example of scorpion is there, you can take the example of cockroach is also going to be taking place, and even the prawn kuda sigade meenanta karithu. Body is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen. As I told you that this is the first time in the animal kingdom it is going to be found andre head and thorax are not getting separated. Head and thorax are fused. The fusion of head and thorax is considered as an cephalothorax anta karithu. Cephalic andre head region, So in this, not necessary to write the character, but in the case of arthropoda you can observe that the molting is also taking place, andre shedding of the skin, and even it is considered as an ecdysis anta kuda karithu. Shedding of the exoskeleton is also called as ecdysis. Spelling here you can see that shedding of the exoskeleton is also considered as molting or ecdysis. So now body is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen. Head, thorax and abdomen, now we can observe that the thorax mattu head both are fused. As I told you that first time in the animal kingdom we are observing modalne sala irodrinda, so that head and thoracic regions are fused, eradu fuse aagtave. So like this, so here you can observe that the usually separation which way takes place, this is the head region, this is the thorax region, like this. But now here separate irodilla, both are combined, head and thorax. This is the abdominal region is going to be found. So head and thorax are going to be fused. This is normally called as cephalothorax. Illi cephalic anta word bartade, cephalic andre head region. Head and thoracic regions are fused to form cephalothorax anta karithu, right? Next is body is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen. Abdomen andre lower region, yarige gottagilla nodri. Usually head, thoracic region, chest region. Ige namage head, neck, chest region ide aa tara irodilla. Thoracic mattu head fuse agirutha. This is called as cephalothorax anta word baruthe. Don't worry about that. Only thing if you are writing this, it is well and good. Head, thorax and abdomen anta karithe. Abdomen andre lower part. Next, sixth one, sensory organs. Sensory organs are present like compound eyes, comma, statocyst, comma, compound eyes, statocyst, comma, antennae. So in this way, compound eyes, statocyst and antennae, as you come across in the case of cockroaches, of the cockroaches nodirabodu, prawns kuda nodirabodu. So we can observe that the alli en irutha andre, these are the compound eyes and the antennae are going to be found here. So these are the compound eyes which is going to be found in the case of cockroach. So cockroach nalli compound eyes irutha, but these eyes specialized characteristics, that is what we are going to be found here. Compound eyes are there. These compound eyes are not able to see in the prominent manner. You can have a kan kanustu athara kanusudilla, but though you can observe that the several images are going to be found here, only you can see that the these are meant for sensation. These compound eyes are mainly meant for the sensation. Okay, now you can see that compound eyes are made up of several visual units also. Around 2000 visual units are going to be found here. Compound eyes are made up of several visual units. So these are supposed to be called as omatidia. Nimma syllabus illa, but now even though I am telling you this, omatidia anta karithu. Omatidia andre the compound eyes are made up of several visual units. These are normally meant for not visual purpose, sensory purpose. You can see that several visual units are called as omatidia anta karithu. Omatidia andre enu, visual units, visual units which is present in the insects. Even you can see that the insects irbodu athwa other prawns also, crustaceans anta karithu, that is also you can observe that the visual units are going to be found. They are called as omatidia anta karithare, right? The compound eyes aithu. Now we have to see that the statocyst andre balancing organ. Illi tail anta na word use madangilla, that is why you can see that the statocyst andre balancing organ. This is normally applying to the even the abdominal part itself, balancing organ. Now antennae, you come across about the here, this is what we are saying, it as an antennae itself. Cockroach nodri maneyalli antennae is going to be found here. So during night time, suppose you switch on the light, not rest sensation, when you switch on the light, suddenly they are moving away from the light. ಯಾಕೆ ಆಗ ಹೋಗ್ತಾವ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ವಿಜುವಲ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಅವ್ಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಹೌದಾ? ದ ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಓನರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್. ಇವನೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯವ ಅಂತಾನಪ್ಪ, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಯಾರು ನಡೀತಂತಲ್ಲ, ಲೈಟ್ ಬಿದ್ದುಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾವ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್ಕೇಪಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿಡೇಟರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಐಸ್, ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟೋಸಿಸ್ಟ್, ಆಂಟನೇ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಥ್ರೋಪೋಡ. ರೈಟ್? ಇವು ಸೆನ್ಸರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ನೌ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸೀ ದಟ್ ಹೌ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ, ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ, ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಾ. ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಇವನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ದ ಗಿಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಟರಿ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್. ಅಥವಾ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಾ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬೋದು, ಇಲ್ಲ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್, ಗಿಲ್ಸ್, ಕಾಮ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚ್, ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚ್ ನೀವು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡೋ ಮುಂದೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್. ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಈ ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚ್ ಬಾಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಹೌ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚ್ ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಇವನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ರಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ರಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಯುನಿಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಇವು ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತವೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಕಾಕ್ರೋಚ್ ಒಂದು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ. ಆನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ರಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೋ ದಿಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್. ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್, ಯುಟಿಲೈಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಫಾಲೋಡ್? ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್. ದ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ನೇಸಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇವನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ದಿ ವಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಏರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಮಾಯಿಸ್ಚರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಏರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಅವೇನು ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಾನಿಂದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತವೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ದಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಈ ಗಿಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಪೋಸ್ ದ ಎನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್, ಗಿಲ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಅದರ್ ಎನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಾ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಾ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಪೇಜಸ್, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೇಜಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಆ ಥರ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತವೆ. ಸೊ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್, ಗಿಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಬುಕ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್. ನೌ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೇಷನ್, 8th ಒನ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇ ದಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಆನ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅನ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್. ನೋಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನಾರ್ಮಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ. ವಾಟ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬಿಂಗ್ ದ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂರಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕಿಡ್ನಿ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಮಾಲ್ಫೀಜಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬಲ್ಸ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಬ್ಲಡ್ನಿಂದ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ತಗೋತವೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್. and they are converting that nitrogenous waste in the form of uric acid. A uric acid anna dump el maartavandre, usually they are dumping in the digestive tube. This once again you are studying the structural organization in animals. Hoda notice so important ide. Now what we are saying, that open circulate system in the case of the arthropoda andre blood is pumped directly out of the heart anta nan helidde. Out of the heart, cells and tissues directly bath into it. At time dali, whatever the waste products are normally found in the cavity, that is collected by the malpighian tubules. That malpighian tubules are converted into uric acid. That uric acid is normally sent to the digestive tube. Why? Because anyway, from the undigested food is sending into the intestine. So this also uric acid also sending through the intestine. That is what we are observing. That other detail bada structural organizational nodthirnu excretion onde thilkore excretion malpighian tubules, they are acting like kidney itself. So now illi nava urination and all those which is going to be taking place separately alla athara irudalla connected to the digestive tube. Convert maadi digestive tube connect aagirthave along with the fecal matter, along with the waste products, they are going to be sent out. So excretion takes place by malpighian tubules. And malpighian tubules are green glands anta baruthu. Idu ondu important character ide. Green glands, especially in the aquatic animals, green glands, example prawn anta baruthu. Green glands book na illa idu green glands that I am giving you now. You can see that the excretion takes place by malpighian tubules or green glands andre all the organisms excretion takes place by malpighian tubules, and those who are aquatic green glands antirutave hoda they are acting like kidney only, right? Next is 9th one, respiration excretion is over. Now we can see that the circulatory system, 9th one, circulatory system is of open type. Circulatory system is of open type hoda circulatory system is of open type comma illi open type blood is colorless. Where do you find colored blood? In the annelida illi colorless blood irutha. Circulatory system is of open type, blood is colorless. Next is 10th one. As we have discussed earlier, ventral nerve cord is also going to be found. Next, fertilization is internal, comma, development is direct or indirect. Some are normally producing the larval stage, some are not producing the larval stage. Usually majority of them they are producing the larval stage, few are there normally they are not producing the larval stage, and they are producing the young one which is similar to the adult scorpion alli nodutini, they are producing the young one avda. And now we can see that the fertilization is internal and even or external also. Those who are present in the aquatic, you can see that the external fertilization is also going to be found. Next one more character, you can see that the illi barithina avda samar oviparous athwa majority are oviparous. But now we can see that majority anta yak baradin andre most of them are oviparous. Only few are there like scorpion, they are normally producing the young one, not the egg. You can see that the one which they are going to produce the egg, they are considering it as an oviparous. The one which is going to produce the young one is considered as an viviparous anta karithevu. Alli viviparous one organism or the animal ide, that is the scorpion which is going to produce the young one, right? Now these characters what we have seen in the case of the arthropoda, example node hoda examples you can observe that the I am writing here example, so many examples are there, but now they have given in a different manner. Iga economical example 1, economically important insects. Economically important insects. Here we are observing that economically important insects are unknown. Economically important insects, as you come to know that, small a, bombyx, small b, apis, small c, lacifer andre lac insect, adha apis andre honey bees, next bombyx andre silk worm. So these are considered as an economically important insects. How the silkworm you got to they are producing silk thread and they are economically important, and apis honeybees are also economically important. Lacifer lac insects, they are also normally economically important. You can observe that they are helpful for the secretion of the wax of the lac anta karithu. They are normally helpful for the production of the wax yakandre we are extracting the resin from this that is why this is an economic important wax anta undu nanipidru wax coating and wax anta gottide nimge gum like substance. So we are normally extracting the lac, that is, or the resin, what we are saying, that so that we are normally making the wax, right? So now these are the economic important insects. Now we are moving toward the next economic important insects. Aitu, now the next one is number 1. Aitu number 2, we can see that gregarious pests andre locust. Gregarious pest, that is the locust. Why it is considered as a gregarious pest? Because normally these are harming to the plant. Gregarious pest andre collectively they are making the harm. Gregarious anta karite gumpagi ondonde antalla. Gregarious pest andre they are normally harming the plants. We can see that, which is andre collectively, that is called as gregarious pest. Pest andre they are making the harm. You can see that pests oda pesticides anta gottide. Gregarious pests andre these are the insects, bunch of insects which is going to be normally form the disease in the case of the plant. That is the example is locust. Next is third one we have to see that the living fossil and ivella one or more question. Living fossil, that is the limulus or king crab anta karithu. That is the living fossil, the looking like the crab, that andre that species may not be found in the earlier species idilla, but now resembling of those species, that is the limulus is going to be visible. That is considered as a living fossil anta karithu. Fossil andre gottide. So now fourth one is vectors. We can see that example anopheles is there, that is the vector of the culex is also there. So now, and even aedes anta bartha, aeds, aedes andre mosquitoes. Vectors andre not the physics definition, vectors not physics definition is going to be found, but now here vectors are nothing but the disease carriers. Anopheles mosquito, they are going to cause a disease, you know that. Culex mosquito anta kuda garithave. So now iveradu enu martave, they are the disease carriers. Mosquitoes, they are the disease carriers andre they are normally collecting the eggs. Female anopheles mosquito anta namu gottide. So now these anopheles mosquito, why the anopheles mosquito only they are going to cause the disease of plasmodium athwa even malaria is going to form anta navu karadre. Why the female anopheles andre female anopheles is only laying the eggs, the females only. Once they are laying the eggs means they are carrying the organisms. Once they are carrying the organism from the water means they are normally liberating into the human body. That is why on the basis of that the anopheles are considered as the carriers of the disease. That is why they are called as vectors. Vectors andre carriers of the disease. Magnitude and direction alla, physics definition alla. So now we can observe that the anopheles and the culex, even we can see that the AIDS anta kuda barthu. AIDS andre not the AIDS. That AIDS are normally AIDS andre mosquitoes. Other mosquitoes are also, they are going to cause the disease. Right. So these are the one the economically important insects. One more question kelabodu, write any one economic important insects andre specific agi you have to write the scientific names. Bombyx, Apis, Lacifer, Lac insect. Hoda idu beka importance nu gottilla andre kuda barkobodu. It is normally andre we are extracting the resin for the preparation of the wax and all those things, you have to write wax. And now gregarious pest andre they are normally making the disease in a group manner, that is called as gregarious pest. Living fossil, limulus or the king crab. Vectors, anopheles or the culex mosquito is also there. Or the elephantiasis, filarial worm, that worms you can see the eggs are going to be normally carried by means of the mosquitoes itself. Right? Okay, now these are the characters what we have studied and we have completed the arthropod. ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪನೂ ನೆನಪಿಡಬೇಕು. ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫೈಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫೈಲಮ್ ಇದೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು? ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದ ಮೊಲಸ್ಕ್. ರೈಟ್? ಓಕೆ, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ನೈಸ್ ಡೇ.